I value myself enough to give 120% or don't do it.
I know iron sharpens iron, and I'm hungry to be around sharp people. He's one of the sharpest people I know.
That's the problem with some of you. You always want to blame other people. You want to hold other people to the fire, but you're not holding yourself to the fire. You just said you're giving 50%. You owe you an explanation.
Just being able to drive and sit in the room with other people that are hungry. There's a lot of energy when you come to something like this, and just being able to hear Eric and hear his passion and look in his eyes and see the people he's influenced.
You owe you an explanation. You need to look at yourself in the mirror and say, why are you only giving 50%? What's wrong with you? You need to put yourself on punishment. You need to tell you that you owe you something.
I enjoyed it. I feel empowered. I feel motivated to go out there and be the best I can be in all areas of life. 120 in everything.
What up, what up, what up, what up? It's your boy E.T. That's right, baby. Welcome to another edition of Bring It From The Bottom. Thank God it's Monday. Woo! All right, guys, we want to do something a little different. Okay, so you've heard, if you give a man a fish, he'll just eat for a day. But if you teach him how to fish, yep, he'll eat for a lifetime. But I want to take it to another level. If you teach him how to buy the river, if you teach him how to buy the lake, if you teach him how to buy the ocean, he'll be able to sell fish for the rest of his life, and he'll be able to get that to generation to generation to generation. So what we're gonna do for you today is we're gonna break down the You Matter video. That's right, we're gonna break down the You Matter video and give you the blueprint, the behind the scenes, the making of TGIM. It's your boy, E.T. So I think the first thing that happened, you know, by the time we got to the You Matter format is that I shipped it from a motivational speaker to a shepherd. You know, and I can't really tell you exactly when it happened, but if you go back to some of the earlier videos, you know, my major concern was, you know, content. My major concern was, you know, making sure I said something deep, you know what I'm saying? But I shifted somewhere, and the focus became, you know, the actual individual. You know, the focus was no longer the content. The focus was no longer, you know, the message. The focus was no more, you know, no longer making sure that, you know, I was passionate, or, you know, the focus became, you know, the people. With this particular video, I'll never forget, I was doing some corporate work, some corporate training for Quicken Loans.
I remember getting that call from Eric, man. We usually talk, like, after each gig, like, if I'm not with him, I'd call and, you know, ask, like, how'd it go? Or he would just call me, like, man, here's what happened at the gig. And this conversation was a little different. Like, this one, he didn't talk anything about his presentation. It was kind of weird for me. I'm like, what's happening? Like, what's going on?
Now, what you have to understand about, you know, E.T. that makes me probably a little different than most motivational speakers is that I try to get to an event and I try to get there early, because I see it not only as an opportunity for me to speak, but as a professional development opportunity. Like, I'm a lifelong learner. So I'm trying to hear all the other speakers. You know, I'm trying to watch the videos. I'm trying to read the dittos. Like, I'm really trying to get engaged and get involved in that environment, right? So that I can get a sense of what the people really need. So I was the only speaker, and then Bill Emerson, which is the CEO of Quicken Loans. And I'm thinking, like, my man about to come and talk to the individuals that are responsible for slushies, like the grape, the watermelon, you know what I'm saying, the lemon lime. Like, honestly, like, these are the people that set up the drinks, like the popcorn, the mixed nuts, the candy. Like, honestly, like, he's about to come from his office to sit down and motivate these individuals. I was like, unbelievable. You know, I finish, he gets up, he starts to do his thing, you know, and he starts to talk about how valuable these individuals are to the company. And it, boom, it hit me like, yup, got it. Like, yup, that's it, I got it. You know, again, he was saying, you guys are valuable, you guys are valuable. And it hit me, you matter. I need you to listen, for real, because I'm going in a total different direction. I want you to know, you matter, all right? No, for real, you gotta listen to him, because this one may not be as deep as the ones that you normally listen to, right? But you gotta get this one within. You matter. So
this organization couldn't run without these people, you know what I mean? And of course, you know, it was immediate, like, we got to figure out how to package this into a TGIM. Of course, you know, for E, he's going to get up and do his thing. And I have to figure out the way now to capture the images. And E does a good job of literally spelling it out. So he will call literal names of who he's talking to, the teachers, the bus drivers. So you can find images for that. But of course, it's more than that. You want to be able to attract, you know, anybody that looks at this video. You don't want it to be, you know, all a certain ethnic group or all a certain nationality. You want to be able to just, you know, cross all that. You know, let's just blur all these lines and just get to humanity.
Matter. Are you hearing me, mother? You're going to change your child's life. Father, if you're not there doing what you're supposed to do as a father, your child is not going to be as a teacher. When you walk in the classroom, you inspire, you change. Listen to me carefully as a counselor, as a guide.
I got to let them know. The housewife who feels like because she's not working and she's not making six figures, the husband whose wife is the worker and he's at home taking care of the kids, like, I have to let that group of people who are valuable, I'm talking about valuable, the store clerk, like the hostess, the, you know, the waiter, the waitress, I gotta let them know, like, yo, forget how much money you make or you don't make, you matter.
Right now, the way you prepare right now, 10 years from now, you've heard me say it before, what you are to be, you're now becoming. If you're gonna be that great doctor, that great teacher, that great lawyer, that great counselor, that great
so
mother,
for me, that was the making. And I remember driving home, and all, I couldn't wait. I had these images and these visions in my head, and I was like, yo, Ken, yo, Carl, like, this one's gonna be hot. And I remember calling Carl and really kind of breaking it down, giving him, because that's a part of the process. As soon as I get it, you know, I'm not the visual guy. I don't make the visualization part happen, but I'm calling him saying, yo, like, I got it. You matter. Like, this is the one. This one's gonna be hot.
In editing, like, you needed to see Eric's face. You know, a lot of times we use B-roll to cover up just so it keeps moving and you're just not, you know, looking at a standing person. But you needed to see Eric because some of the things he was saying, like, he spoke directly to you as the person watching this video.
I'm discouraged a little bit. I'm getting emails from people who thinking about committing suicide, people who giving up in school, people who just giving up and giving in. They ready to get a divorce. Like, I got people, like, you ain't even fought yet. You ain't even fought hard yet, and you ready to give up.
You know, as an editor, I get it first. So it's not like we were preparing this thing and giving it out to the world. He gets something, he internalizes it, and it has an impact on his life. Now, as I'm editing, it's changing me. So I know if I can feel it, nah, I want you to experience what I'm experiencing. So, like, it's just for me to now take this thing and just mold it in a way that when you see it, you know, the music, everything just adds to the experience that you get.
Again, it goes back to making that shift from a motivational speaker, you know, and doing this thing to sound sweet, you know, to a shepherd, really caring about the people and making sure that every single week when I do a TGIM, I feel their heart and they feel my passion. Like, I'm in the room with them. Like, they get goosebumps. They like, yo, I matter. Like, I want to make sure that at the end of that video that they get it. They get the point. And then they begin to operate in a way that they weren't operating before because they didn't necessarily see the value in it.
Listen to me very closely. I need you to hear these words. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful. Powerful beyond measure. It's our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, to be gorgeous, to be talented, to be fabulous?
So I had to let that concierge know. I had to let that mother know. I had to let that waitress know. I had to let that nurse know. I had to let that teacher know, like, you do matter. We need you, right? And you go in there and you operate like you matter. So for me, that was the making of that particular video, and I'm gonna be honest. Once it was over, Carl sent it to me, and I saw it. I was like, "Yep, this one's gonna go. This is a classic. This is one people are gonna be able to use year after year, month, week after. Yep, and not only use it in their own personal life, but this is one of those videos that when somebody's down and out, somebody's gonna be able to say, "Yo, you, hold on. Let me send you this link. Yeah, oh, hey, go to YouTube. You matter. Look up that video." So I was very, very pleased. When I saw the video, I was very pleased because I felt like visually Carl brought to life, you know, what I actually had in my head. So we don't want to just teach you how to fish. You know, we want you to own the lake, own the river, own the pond. So not only that you could eat, but you could feed generations to come.
The glory of God. that is within us. It is not in some of us, it's in all of us. And as we let our light shine, we unconsciously give others permission to do the same. And when we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. I value myself enough to give 120% or don't do it.
I know iron sharpens iron, and I'm hungry to be around sharp people. He's one of the sharpest people I know.
That's the problem with some of you. You always want to blame other people.